A very good morning to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can use PowerPoint as a picture tool or a thumbnail generator. So sleepless night, so thought to create this video for you. So let's get started and have a look at my YouTube channel. And these are a few of my recent published video, and all these thumbnails that you are seeing here has been created in PowerPoint. So that is the topic, that how you can use PowerPoint easily to create thumbnails or any picture that you want. And here I would also like to show you my website, and here you can see that duck animation tutorial. And all these screenshots that I have embedded here has been created through PowerPoint, except for these GIF files. However, I have also published a tutorial that how you can convert your PowerPoint presentation into GIF files, but these are the custom GIF files with this. The size are and the dimensions are according to the requirement of my website that I need here. So I have not created these GIF files through PowerPoint. However, you can do that, but the problem is with the PowerPoint is that you cannot define custom GIF file size when you try to export them. So that is why I use Camtasia Studio to create these GIF files. However, all these thumbnails that you are seeing here, all these screenshots that I have embedded into my articles on PowerPoint animations, all these thumbnails has been created in PowerPoint. So that is what I am going to teach you today. And when you open the PowerPoint for the first time, the first screen that you see, that is called the welcome screen. And here if you click on the new, then you see all the ready-made templates that PowerPoint provides you. And if you have an internet connection, then you might see more templates here. Like you can see different kind of categories here. And let's say if I choose any of them, let's say this one, and then you have more choices to choose colors from, like this one, and then click create. Then you have this template on your PowerPoint slide. And if you go to the design menu, then you can see the design ideas which can further improve the design of this template. Like if I click on this, then it will automatically change the layout of the text boxes and the background. So that is up to you that which template or which design idea you want to apply. The thing is that if let's say I type here something. So let's say we have this template with the this background and the text boxes, and now I want to save this slide as a JPG file so I can later upload it to my YouTube channel. Then what I can do, I can click on the file menu and then click on save as, click browse to define the location and the file type. So let's say I want to save this file on the desktop with this name Microsoft PowerPoint, but I want to save it as JPG. And then click on save. Then PowerPoint will ask you that if you want to save all the slides of this presentation as different JPG files. So let's say if you have 10 slides on your presentation, then it will automatically create 10 different JPG files for each of these slides. So if I click on the all slide button, as now I only have one slide on this presentation, so it doesn't matter if I click on all slides or just this one. So let's say I click on just this one and minimize this PowerPoint, and here we have that JPG file that I can use in YouTube or any other social media websites. So let me close it. And if you right click on this file and choose properties, and then if you go to the details and scroll down, then here you can see the default resolution that PowerPoint applies when you save the slide as a JPG. However, I have also created a tutorial on how to convert your PowerPoint presentation into JPG files, and the link of these videos are also given in the descriptions and in the cards. And the default resolution that PowerPoint applies when you save any of your slide or a presentation into JPG file is 1280 into 720. So you should remember that. And if now I go to my YouTube channel and edit any of my video, and here if I go to custom thumbnail, this one here, and then I click to change, then I can choose that picture that I recently saved as JPG file. So that way I have applied different kinds of thumbnail to each of my video tutorial that I am uploading on YouTube, as you can see here. So here I have another presentation, the girl realistic animation in PowerPoint, and you can see the slide here with a white background. But if I open the selection pan from the home tab by clicking on the select drop down button and choose selection pan, and then here you can see all the objects that I have drawn using the shape tools. And if you want to learn more about how to use shape tool, which is necessary if you want to use PowerPoint as a picture tool or a thumbnail generator, then you must have a deep knowledge of how to use shape tool. These ones in the insert tab, if you click on the shape drop down button, then you can see all types of shapes here, and these shapes are very much necessary if you want to create very attractive thumbnails for your YouTube channel. So beside that, you also should have a good knowledge of how to use WordArt and symbols. So as you can see here, there are a lot of objects, but in the slide you only see a white background with this green rectangle and this blue rectangle, but there you can see a lot of objects in the selection pan. So what is happening here, if I select this one, that is a white rectangle on top of the other objects, and here you can see the list of objects here, and if I turn off all these light objects, then you can see the curve. So the point is, when you try to save your slide as a JPG file, then it will automatically save those objects which are visible in the selection pan. So as I have turned off all these light objects here, and if now I go to file, save as, browse for a location, name it and change the file type to JPG, and change the location to desktop and click save, just this one, and minimize it. So here we have that file in JPG format. So when you export your slide as a JPG file, then only those objects which are visible in the selection pan will appear in the JPG file. That is the point. So if I again open this file and go to the insert tab and choose WordArt, and here I choose this style and change the font color to white. So here I can type realistic animation in PowerPoint, Microsoft PowerPoint tutorial. So I can move and place it right here, and if I want to apply a background to this, then I can fill a shape color, or I can even move it to down right here and change the text box size. That is why I was telling you that if you want to use PowerPoint as a thumbnail generator, then you should have a very good knowledge of shape tools. And I want to reduce the size of the font, or I can move this tutorial thing to the upper line and then drag this rectangle down here. So now if I will save this file, then all these objects will be included into JPG. So I name it the girl 2 on desktop, save it as JPG, then click save, just this one, minimize, and here we have another file, the girl. So all the objects that I have drawn, the world art, the rectangle, the shape fill color, has been included into the JPG file. So I also want to show another PowerPoint presentation here. So here you can see one of the screenshots from my duck animation tutorial, and you can also see that on the top of the screenshot I have drawn many of the rectangles and the arrows, and when I will save this presentation as JPG file, then it will include all these shapes and the background picture and will create a single JPG file. So let me show you another example here. If I again open this girl animation presentation and delete this one, let's say if I want to print, embed this entire screen into one of the article that I have written on this animation here. So what I can do, I can hold down the start key and then press print screen to take the screenshot of the entire screen. Now if I open a new slide by pressing Ctrl N, or you can also click on file and then choose new. So inside the new presentation, if you click on the paste button, then it will grab the screenshot from the clipboard and will paste into the PowerPoint slide. So once I have this screenshot here inside the PowerPoint, what I can do if I want to point out things here, so I can go to the insert tab, click the shapes drop down button, and here I can choose this arrow and draw it right here, and then change the shape outline. First I will change the weight, and then I will change the color to red, and now I will draw another rectangle here, and here I want to add text, so I can do by right clicking on it and choose edit text, and here I would like to type thumbnail view. Now I will click on file, save as, browse, and then go to desktop, let it name presentation 1 and save it as JPG, just this one, minimize it, and let's see the presentation 1, and here you have all the objects inside the JPG file. So as you know, I am embedding all these JPG file inside my articles on my website, so the size of these JPG file really does matter. So if I close this one and right click on any of these JPG file and choose properties and go to the details section, then here you can see the size of the file, which is 59.7 KB. So besides saving your PowerPoint slide as JPG file, there is another way to save your slide as JPG files, or you can also change the file type to PNG. So I would also like to show you that trick as well. So let's say if I again go to this presentation and take the screenshot by pressing start and print screen, and now I open a new slide and paste the screenshot here, and let's say I draw something on top of this slide, let's say an oval here, and change the transparency of this oval to, let's say, 50%. So the another thing that you can do, you can select all the objects by pressing Ctrl A, or you can also go to the home tab and then click on select drop down button and choose select all, and then click on the cut from the home tab. So the another thing that you can do in PowerPoint to save your all the objects as picture by first selecting all of them and then choose cut, and then right click on an empty area of the slide and choose paste as picture. So now all the objects have combined into a single picture. Now what I can do, either I can save this slide now as a JPG, or you can also right click on this picture here and go to save as picture, and here you can choose the file type, and here you have different file types. However, there is no use of saving this picture as GIF file because it will not animate at all. However, the difference could be in the file size. So I will now save this picture using this save as picture option here by right clicking on the picture and then choose save as picture, and I will save it into two different types, JPG and PNG, and then we will compare the size of all the three type file types that we have used, saving as JPG file and then right clicking and save as picture as JPG or PNG. Then we will compare the size of all these three files. So if I now click on JPG and name it picture 1, click save, again right click save as picture, then PNG picture 2, save, and third one by clicking on file, save as, browse, and then JPG. And let me name it picture 3. Save, just this one, minimize. So now we will compare the size of all these three different pictures that we have created using three different methods. So let's first check the size of this one, picture one, that we saved by right clicking on the picture and then choose save as picture, and then we choose JPG. So if we go to the properties, go to details and scroll down, the size is 224 KB. The size really does matter if you write blogs or you are maintaining a website. So the size of picture really does matter in the websites and blogs, so you have to take care of that. So by saving your slide as a picture using the JPG format, the size is 224 KB. And if we see the size of picture 2, which is in PNG format, and you can also see the resolution here, the resolution is larger than the saving as JPG format. So if we scroll down, the size is larger, 593 KB. And finally, if we see the size of this one, picture 3, that we exported using the file save as option JPG. So if we scroll down, the resolution is 1280x720. And the size is smaller than all the other sizes, 124 KB. And finally, if we see the size of this girl JPG file that we created earlier, the resolution is same. And if we scroll down, and you can see the size is smaller than all. So the best option is to draw all the things or screenshot or pictures that you want to insert into your slide and then save them as using the file save as option, browse, and then choose the JPG file. That way it will create a smaller size file. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to my channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.